Major funding for KidVision Mission is brought to you in part by
the Children's Services Council of Broward County supports KidVision and public television. We are dedicated to enriching children's lives and empowering them to become responsible and productive adults.
It's time for a field trip. KidVision kids, can you guess what I'm doing?
Coloring!
I'm coloring. And look what I colored. Who is that?
Shiny!
It's Shiny. Shiny's gonna love it. It makes me feel so proud when I do art. I love to color and draw and paint. It just makes me feel proud. When you feel proud, you feel good about the things that you do. And the nice thing about art is it can be something that looks like something, or it can be abstract, which means it doesn't have to look like anything at all except what's in your imagination. I hear a KidVision Mission file. Let's see what it is. KidVision Kids, that's Miss Stephanie, and she's an artist. Are you ready for a
KidVision Mission?
For our first activity, we're going to draw outer space monsters. And we're going to see lots of different shapes in the legs, in the arms, and the bodies. Some triangles, some circles, some wiggly shapes, some geometric shapes. Some familiar shapes, some unfamiliar shapes, and it's gonna be lots of fun. We're gonna start with a drawing activity where we have these big dice where the kids get to roll them and it determines the fate of their outer space monster. This is the dice for the legs, okay? So every side has a pair of interesting legs that maybe an outer space monster would have. This is the body dice, so we're gonna flip it and see what it lands on, and you'll be able to draw that body. So this is gonna determine which body you get, and everybody's gonna get a turn to roll the dice. The eyes, that's good. I do not want your drawing to look exactly like this, okay? Don't make it, you better not look exactly like this. I want it to be your version. That's okay too. Whatever you do is correct. Next, I want a big high roll. Spin it in the air. Oh, that's a good one too. Oh, we got the squiggly body. So let that be your inspiration. Are we supposed to make mistakes in here?
Yeah.
What happens is can anybody raise a quiet hand and tell me what happens when you make a mistake? Violet?
It's okay.
It's okay? What else happens?
Your brain grows.
Do you know why?
You learn from your mistakes.
Now that we have our monster bodies with our arms, legs, bodies, and faces, and tails, I think we're ready to add some color. So, what do you think about painting?
Yes!
Okay. It is now time to switch out our pencils for something else. Who knows what this is?
Paintbrush.
Violet. A paintbrush, yes. What do we do with a paintbrush?
We paint,
right? And do you notice that there's something else in front of us? It's an easel, very good. What does an easel do?
It's a thing to hold up my canvas.
Yeah, absolutely, you can hold up your canvas. Right now we're using clipboards to put our drawings on. That's right, so we have easel and a paintbrush, and we're gonna bring out some paints, and we're gonna paint our monsters.
But how will we paint color?
That's a great question. I am going to hand out some water, and you can wash your brush in between, and I'll show you how. And then you have a rag to wipe it off. So you'll also see that you have two different size paintbrushes. Why do you think you have two different size paintbrushes?
This one's for painting and this one's just for the details.
that's a good word, details, that's right. The details are the small things, like maybe your eyeballs or a detail on your tail. And this is for big things, maybe your body where you have lots of area to paint. So I'm gonna hand out the paints now and then we can get started.
If you mix red and yellow, it makes orange. You want me to show you?
Yeah.
You can try it. Here, you can use my paintbrush. So put it in here, put a little bit of red, and then put a little bit of yellow. Here, you can use this one. And then mix them together and see what color it is. What's happening? What color is it turning? It's turning orange, look at that. It's time to reveal our masterpieces. Monsters in Outer Space.
3, 2, 1, turn it around. Whoa.
Wow. These paintings are really amazing. Paintings of objects in outer space. Shiny, you did it too. Shiny did an abstract. KidVision Kids, it's time to make art in a different way.
Splashroom is a magical place where you can make a mess like you've always wanted to. So you take paint, you can throw it at the walls, you can mess it around on the floor, you can even paint your own body. And it is complete freedom. And I know that you naturally want to do that all the time. But this is the place where you can actually do it and you won't get in trouble.
Wow, this art class was so much fun. Art is an amazing way to use your superpower of imagination to express yourself, even in outer space.
Bye!
Hi, KidVision Kids, it's Miss Penny. Put on your thinking caps. It's time to learn some new words. Art class. An art class for kids is where you draw, paint, and expand your imagination and creative art skills using art materials. What was that word?
Art class!
Good job! Easel. An easel is a support where you can place your artwork so that it's facing towards you rather than laying flat on a table. What was that word?
Easel!
Good job! Sensory bin. A sensory bin has elements and items that excite and stimulate 4 out of 5 senses. Touch, smell, sight, and hearing. What was that word?
Sensory bin!
Good job! Splash room. A splash room is a designated area where it's okay to get messy and play with splatter paint. What was that word?
Splatter!
Good job! I am having so much fun doing art today. I don't want to stop doing it. So we're going to do an activity that you can do along with me at home. Today we're going to make a collage, a paper collage, and it's going to be abstract, which means it doesn't have to look like anything except what you want it to be. So we're going to start by tearing paper. I have a bunch of colors of construction paper and a piece of cardboard that I'm going to use to tape it on. But you can use any kind of paper. Just ask your parents if it's okay that you tear it up. And then I need some glue or tape or something to put it on. So we start by tearing. Have you ever torn a piece of paper?
Yes!
It's really fun. You put one hand this way, and the other hand like that, and then you push one towards you and one away from you, and you tear it. And then you can tear it again. And tear it again. So you put your fingers together and leave a little space in the middle so you can tear it. And it doesn't have to tear straight. Sometimes it will, sometimes it won't, but it's really fun. It's really fun to tear paper. And you can make little tiny pieces. I like the little tiny, tiny pieces. Or if I have a green piece of paper, or you can even just use copy paper. Look, let's see, let's try to make, oh, let's make a really long tear. Can you hear that? Amazing. Let's make another one. Oh, wow. I'm proud of myself. That was a good tear. Let me try another one. Let's see how this one works. Oh, nice job. See, I'm proud of myself. I did a good job. So now it's time to collage. I have my torn paper. I think this is all the colors I want to use. And I have my base paper. And this could be anything. You could use a box. Oh, it's fun to collage on a box, and it makes it very colorful. You won't even need wrapping paper. You'll be making your own. And I need something to stick it with. I'm gonna use glue, but you could use tape. If you've seen people wrap presents, they use tape, but we're gonna use glue. So first I'm gonna glue my long piece of paper. And I don't wanna make puddles. I'm gonna make a long line. It goes right along, see? And then put it on the paper. And I can put it any way I want because this is abstract art, which means it doesn't have to look like anything. I can just use my imagination and put my paper wherever I want. Oh, somehow I have an orange paper. Let's add that. That must have been from a different art project. So that's very nice. Should we put another long green one on?
Yes.
Okay. Glue on. I know children who like to make puddles of glue. What they do is they make a puddle of glue and then they put their paper right in the middle of the puddle and stick it down. And that works too. Then it's really glued down. Look at that. I'm very proud of my artwork. It's easy to do and fun, and the most important thing is that you have fun doing it. Good job. Let's explore another kind of art called sculpture.
My name is Lisa McNamara. I'm an artist and a teacher, and the kids around here call me Mrs. Mac.
So tell us a little bit about the garden.
Planted in this garden are palms, very rare palms and cycads from all over the world. This was the dream of sculptor Ann Weaver Norton.
That's a lovely idea, and how wonderful for her to make that dream come true. You as an artist, how does this garden inspire you?
What's so inspiring about being here at the gardens is the plant life. You will see all different kinds of patterns in every plant that's here.
So you started as an artist and then you morphed into teaching art.
Yes.
What made you take that step?
The inspiration of making mistakes. I see kids that get so frustrated about they think they're messing up on their paper and they really aren't. It's just another way to look at something.
We're here here at the reflection pool in the garden, and it's just lovely.
Yes, it is.
It's amazing how the sculpture is so beautiful and strong and big, and then when it reflects in the water, it becomes a whole nother piece of art.
I agree. With it reflecting in the water and the water moving, it almost makes it look like a whole nother sculpture. It in itself is a very linear, which means a lot of lines in it, and then the water softens those lines out.
Like you said, it's straight and it's three-dimensional because you can go on all three sides and look at it.
You can walk around it and it has mass to it and volume. A person, we are three-dimensional because we're around. 2D is something flat, where it stays on the plane and it's a piece of paper.
I love your shirt.
Oh, thank you, Miss Penny. The kids call me Mrs. Mac, and this is my idea shirt. I love it because art is all about ideas, isn't it?
So I was thinking that we could start with what you were talking about with a two-dimensional picture and then make it into a three-dimensional piece of art.
Great idea. You got these leaves, mm-hmm. and they're beautiful leaves, and it's a very simple thing. You just do a quick sketch. It doesn't have to be exact. And when we touch something, sometimes that helps us to go ahead and draw it. And this is a beautiful, simple leaf. If you're trying this at home, what you might do is make one triangle and then make another triangle. And you pretty much have a leaf. And since this leaf is very flat, we want to go ahead and give it more volume so it will kind of blossom up a little bit.
Okay.
I think I'm going to start mine out into kind of like a worm, okay. so it has some volume to it. And then you're pressing, you're looking at the little triangle at the top. And what's so great about clay is it molds to pretty much whatever you want it to do.
Look at that.
Yep. That looks great to me.
It does. Our leaves are very different, and it's been so wonderful working with clay. It's amazing how we're both looking at the same leaf, but we both have different interpretations of it.
Exactly. That's what makes art so cool. You see something one way and develop it, and I see something another way and develop it.
When we were by the reflection pool and we saw Ann Norton's structure, and it was so beautiful and well done, and you were talking about that we could play with that idea and use Legos.
Yes, we can. We have Legos right here. Let's do it. Make a 3D structure.
One of the things I liked about the structure, besides the reflection in the pond, mm-hmm. is I liked that it went up and there was an empty space in the middle.
Yes. So that empty space is called negative space, where you can see through something. If you open up your fingers right here, this is negative space. And any kind of sculpture, an artist is always looking for negative space because that, it's almost two sculptures in one, the negative space and then the solid stuff.
Very interesting. Yes. I never thought of it like that. Happy with my structure, and I love the negative space. Thank you for telling me about it. Now when I'm building, I'll think about that.
I think it's wonderful, and it definitely shows the flavor of Ann Norton's piece looking at the reflection pond.
And let's look at your structure.
So mine has a little bit more solidness to it. It does have some negative space here, and there was another piece in the garden that I have that flavor from, mm-hmm. that this was the center point, because that's what you kind of look at, is that negative space in there.
I want to thank you so much. It was wonderful to spend the day with an artist and to take art apart and really be in a beautiful sculpture garden and be inspired by Ann Norton's work. And then you doubly inspired me.
Oh, thank you.
And taught me so much.
Oh, Miss Penny, that was very kind of you. Thank you. It was wonderful. And the surrounding is just absolutely amazing.
Hi, KidVision kids. It's Miss Penny. Put on your thinking caps. It's time to learn some new words.
Art studio. An art studio is a room where an artist does his or her work. It is a place where an artist works and creates.
What was that word?
Art studio.
Good job.
Artist. An artist is a person who works doing creative arts, like drawing, painting, or sculpture.
What was that word?
Artist.
Good job.
Sculpture. A sculpture is a work of art that is made by carving or shaping clay, stone, or other materials into a three-dimensional figure.
What was that word?
Sculpture.
Good job.
Sculpture garden. A sculpture garden is an outdoor garden dedicated to the presentation of sculptures.
Sculpture garden.
Good job. KidVision kids, that was a great field trip. I really enjoyed it. I'm sure you did too. Art is magical. It's fun and creative and just great to be around. It makes you happy. And I know something that's gonna make you really, really happy. I have a friend whose name is Paige Turner, and she tells great stories. So to get her here, we have to say, once upon a time. When I count to three, all together, we're gonna say, once upon a time, and she'll appear. Are you ready? One, two, three.
Once upon a time.
Whoa. Hi, Miss Penny.
Hi, Paige Turner.
Oh, I'm so happy to be here. Miss Penny, I have a story for you.
Oh, I knew it.
And this is a story all about a magical sculpture garden.
Perfect.
But you know what? I need your help. Can you help me?
Yes.
Okay, you're going to be the artist in this story.
Okay.
And KidVision kids, I need your help too. You're going to be the sculptors in this story. You're going to make your body into a shape and freeze and don't move. But whenever the artist leaves, you are going to move and dance all around the sculpture garden. But as soon as she comes back, you have to freeze again and don't move. Okay? All right. Oh, wait a minute. Miss Penny, I said this is a magical story and we're going to be in a magical sculpture garden, right?
Right.
Do you think that we could have Shiny help us spread a little bit of magic?
Absolutely.
Okay, should we call Shiny?
Yes.
How do we do it?
We count to three.
Okay.
One, two, three,
Shiny!
Oh, hi, Shiny. Shiny, could you help us with the story today? Okay, good. Can you sprinkle some magical stardust?
Great.
Thank you, Shiny. Okay, let's start the story.
Okay.
When I count to three, we'll say once upon a time. Here we go.
One, two, three.
Once upon a time.
Once upon a time, there was a magical sculpture garden. Can you be the sculptors in the sculpture garden? Good job.
Looking good.
The artist looked at her sculptures and then she left the garden.
Oh, I love my sculptures. I'm gonna go make some more.
As soon as the artist leaves, what do, sculptures? Yep, we dance and move and have fun all around the garden. But uh-oh, the artist is coming back. Freeze.
Hey, something looks different here. I think I'm gonna go do some more work.
And the artist leaves, what do? Yep, come to life and dance and move. And spin, but uh-oh, when the artist comes back, freeze.
There is definitely something going on around here. I'm gonna go hide and see what happens.
plants. So the artist hid behind a rock in the garden. But you didn't know she was there. And so you come to life. One more time, sculptors, come here. Here we go. We're going to dance and sing. And, well, we're not going to sing, but we are going to dance.
Wait a minute.
Oh, you try to freeze. But the artist saw you.
Yes, I did.
You know what? I guess art really is
magic.
And so the sculptures and the artist danced all around the garden. Here we go. And Miss Penny, guess what?
What?
That's
the end.
Good job. Thank you.
I loved it.
Thank you, KidVision Kids. And you know what? It's time for me to go on another adventure.
Okay.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
That was amazing. You know what? Art is magical. KidVision Kids, you did a great job using your imagination and your creativity. I'm very proud of you, and you should be proud of you. We're gonna count to three and say mission accomplished. Are you ready? One, two, three,
mission accomplished!
Good job. See you next time.
We're on a KidVision mission. With Miss Penny, a KidVision mission. And Shiny too, helping friends with what they do. We're on a KidVision mission with you. So much to learn, so much to see. KidVision Kids, come along with me. Miss Penny and Shiny gonna lead the way. Adventure on, we'll save the day. We're on a KidVision mission. With Miss Penny, a KidVision mission. And Shiny too, helping friends with what they do.
Major funding for KidVision Mission is brought to you in part by
the Children's Services Council of Broward County supports KidVision and public television. We are dedicated to enriching children's lives and empowering them to become responsible and productive adults.